So we have our next problem. Dito ko na lang i-discuss yung correction ko sa length ng cable. And then I also included another problem na ano tawag dito? Unsymmetrical yung cable. So yan yung isosolve natin. So for this problem, the cable shown daw carries a uniform load of 5 kN/m. Now first, we have to determine the minimum tension in the cable. Now this is a symmetrical parabolic cable, so we can just cut this sa center. Yan. And then, copy natin. So ito na yung half ng cable. Yung minimum tension, the minimum tension occurs dyan sa lowest point. So, label natin as, wait lang. Yan, label natin to as FH. Yan. And then, meron tayong distributed load na, 5 kN/m. Yan, sulat natin. 5 kN/m. And then, therefore, this has a resultant pala na nag-a-act sa gitna, which is equal to 5 multiplied by, diba, this is a symmetrical parabolic cable. So, yung 240, madi-divide lang yan by 2. So, this is, yung horizontal distance is half of 240, which is 120 meters. So 5 times 120, this gives us 600. Yan. And so to solve FH pala, yung moment arm pala nito is 600 yan. That acts sa gitna. So this distance is half of 120 pala. So half of that is, 60. Yan. Or you can just use WX square mo and then divide by 2. Now we can take moments about A. So meron tayong negative FH multiplied by itong distance na to is this one, 36. So minus FH times 36. And then plus, 600 multiplied by 60. Yan. Or, you can just simply write 5 kN/m multiplied by 60. Anong tawag dito? Wait lang. 120. 120 squared divided by 2. This comes from WX squared over 2. Yan. So, set natin to 0. Solve natin yung FH. So, 600 times 60 divided by 36. We have 1,000. So, FH equals 1,000 kN. So this is the minimum tension. So ito pala, letter B. Yan. And then, to determine the maximum tension of the cable, andito yan siya sa support. So, yung maximum tension, it occurs kung saan mas mahaba yung horizontal distance. But ito kasi, since symmetrical parabolic cable lang, equal yung dalawang sides, dito 120, sa kabila 120 din. So, the maximum tension may occur at A or at B. The same lang sila. So, we can analyze this part. Dito sa A, meron siyang tension. Yan. And then yung components ng tension at A would be FH and W. So we can draw a triangle. So this is W. Ito naman yung FH. Yan. And then the angle with respect sa horizontal, sabihin natin theta. So considering this triangle, 'di ba, that's a right triangle. So yung TA pala is just the resultant of W and FH. Now yung W is the total weight, yung resultant niya. So TA pala is square root of W natin, 600, and then FH is ito, 1000. So plus 1000 squared. Yan. So 600 squared plus 1000 squared, this is 1166.19. And this is KN. So ito na yung maximum tension. It will occur sa supports talaga. So max tension. Yan. So we have letter C. And then for the next problem, determine the angle that the maximum tension makes with the horizontal. Yan yung theta. So considering this triangle, ito yung opposite side, ito naman yung adjacent side. So we can use the tangent function. So tan theta equals W opposite over adjacent. Yan. So by the way, gagawin na lang natin tong W total. Yan. Kasi you may confuse this with the magnitude of the uniform load. So ito na lang. So arctan pala, theta is arctan of 600, yan yung W total, divided by 1000, which is FH. So shift tan, 600 over 1k, this is 30.96. Yan. So yung sagot pala natin is itong letter B. Yan. Now for the length of the cable naman, we have to use this formula. Ang tawag dito, yung arc length will be square root of 1 plus dy over dx squared, and then integrate natin, and then we have our differential element. So this is from 0 up to a certain value of x. Yan. So let's just say x1. Yan. So itong dy over dx, diba, the equation of a parabola is defined by y equals kx squared. Yan. So differentiate natin to once, magiging y prime, or diba, yung y prime is dy over dx. Yan, differentiate natin with respect to x. So yung 2, andyan na yan sa front. So 2 multiplied by k, kx, and then minus tayo ng 1 sa exponent, magiging 1 na lang din. So magiging 2kx pala yung dy over dx. Yan. So itong dy over dx, let's replace that with this formula. And then, sa formula na to, yan, di ba, we can define this as k equals, divide natin by x squared yung dalawang sides, magiging y over x squared. So yung y, yan yung height ng parabola, yung x squared naman, yung x is the horizontal distance. So this simplifies into S pala is equal to the integral from 0 to x1 and then square root of 1 plus dy over dx is 2kx. So 2, ano pala yan, dapat inside sa parenthesis, and then k natin is y over x squared, so y over x squared and then multiplied by ano yun, x. So ito, this is this corresponds to x1. Yan. And then we have to square this expression. Ito naman, just retain this as a variable. This is what we are trying to integrate. And then we have dx. So we can first analyze this part and then multiply na lang natin by 2 yung length nito, kasi for the other side equal lang din yung length niya. But this is only true for symmetrical parabolic cables. So try down natin. If this is our formula, yan, then this is now, what is x1? X1 is from here up to here, we have a distance of 120 meters. So S pala is from 0 to 120. Yan. And then square root of 1 plus 2kx. So 2 multiplied by, ano yung y niya? Yung height is 36. So lagay natin 36 divided by x1 squared. So x is, it has a distance of 120. Yan. So 120 pala. Square natin. And then meron tayong x. Retain that as a variable and then square natin. Lagyan natin ng dx. So by using our calculators, we can solve the value of s. But take note na itong s, this only accounts for one side. Yung length lang na yan. It doesn't account for this length. But since symmetrically yung cable, we can just multiply this by 2 to get the total length. Yan, sabihin natin ST yan. So multiply lang natin by 2 yung expression na to. Yan, to account for the two sides. So lagay natin 2 times the integral from 0 to 120. And then square root of 1 plus ano yan, 2 times 36 over 120 squared multiplied by x, and then square natin. So we have 253.7. Yan. So, ito na yung sagot natin. By the way pala, itong formula natin, dapat magsa-start siya talaga from 0 up to a certain distance. So, this is important para sa unsymmetrical parabolic curves. So, 253.7, ito lang yan, letter C. Yan. So, I hope this is clear.